please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. Well, 1 year ago, the government rolled out the goods and services tax. It has been an up and down journey for that particular tax regime. But to mark the occasion, the government is holding an event at the Ambedkar International Center in the capital. The interim finance minister, Piyush Goyal, is in attendance along with top North Block officials and tax authorities. You can see the live visuals on your screen, and it is expected that Mr. Piyush Goyal as well as Mr. Arun Jaitley will shortly make speeches on that, and we will cut in for those speeches. But moving on and talking about how GST is really impacting businesses on ground. Bhiwandi in Maharashtra has been the hub for powerloom industry. The industry was largely unorganized when it came under GST net last year. The tax regime actually caused quite a bit of shock and many businesses simply unraveled. A year since, the power loom industry in Bhiwandi is still crawling back to life. CNBC TV18's Archana Shukla reports that many companies are still grappling with issues due to lack of capital, subdued demand due to increased compliance and the additional burden of filing intrastate e-way bills.
Sleepy town of Bhiwandi buzzing for all these years. It's their main economy driver, and the people working here have been happy despite poor infrastructure in this region. For the last 1.5 years, with multiple policy changes from demonetization to GST, has meant the industry, which is largely unorganized here, has not been able to keep pace.
Government incentives to reduce tax on inputs and bring down compliance requirements had provided a bit of a breather. And small loom operators in Bhiwandi moved from being on the brink of collapse a year ago to just about surviving. But not everyone has been so lucky.
2005 तक बहुत अच्छा था इधर बिजनेस करने के लिए इतना लग रहा था और करने का ऐसा लग रहा था अभी धीरे-धीरे था ना ये लूम सुबह उठते लूम याद आए डर लग रहा है ऐसा पोजीशन आ गया.
For Raju and his co-workers who get power loom projects on contract from bigger manufacturers, business has been difficult to come by.
इससे पहले तो हमारा 6 लाख का टर्नओवर होता था हफ्ता महीने में अभी क्या 2.5 लाख भी नहीं हो रहा है ऐसा पोजीशन आ गया
पिछले एक साल में
बैंक से लोन्स ले रहे हैं और टाइम पे लोन्स भर नहीं पा रहे अभी पिछले 1 साल से तो हम लोन्स पे चल रहे विदाउट लोन्स में हम लोग बिजनेस कर ही नहीं पा रहे
तो सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम आप लोगों को जीएसटी में किस चीज से हो रही है
जो बड़े बड़े पार्टीज है सामने उनको माल बिक रहा नहीं है हम लोग हमारा पेमेंट रुक रहे हैं दो दो तीन तीन महीने का पेमेंट रुक रहे हैं वो हिसाब से हम लोग टर्न ओवर कर नहीं पा रहे और हम लोग का वो टाइम पे हमको मजदूरी मिलता था कि अभी 1 मीटर के पीछे हमको 6 रुपये मिलता था अभी हमको 5 रुपये कर दिया उसमें भी हमको लॉस हो गया.
It's been over a month since the e-way bills have been implemented for intra-state transport of goods as well. And when we reached Bhiwandi, we realized that is one sore point for transporters as well as small manufacturers.
पहली बात तो हम लोग को बहुत तकलीफ हो रही है लोकल ट्रांसपोर्ट वाले के लिए क्योंकि माल एक जगह प्रोसेस होता है फिर एक जगह पैकिंग होता है दूसरे का ऑफिस में जाता है वो हिसाब से ई वे बिल बनाते बनाते जो है ना हम लोग भी उतना कर नहीं पा रहे हैं पार्टी भी इतना
कई बार ई बिल निकालना पड़ता है सबको ई बिल निकालना पता नहीं होता जो छोटे हम ट्रांसपोर्टर हैं हमारे खुद के पास कोई लैपटॉप पीसी नहीं है जिससे हम इसको निकाल सके बना सके हमको फिर ओनर के पास जाना पड़ता है ओनर सब टाइम पे मिलता है कि नहीं मिलता है
10 किलोमीटर के अंदर जो ई वे बिल का दायरा लगाया है वो गलत है.
अच्छा
10 किलोमीटर के ई वे बिल से गवर्नमेंट को क्या फ़ायदा है मालूम नहीं है लेकिन यहाँ के आदमियों को बहुत हैरानी हो रही है.
आप लोग अगर पहले 100% काम करते थे तो अभी कितना कम हो गया आपका?
40% 60% कम हो गया मैडम काम 40% पे आके रुक गया.
Experts say Bhiwandi small operators are losing their cost competitiveness, especially with the balance of power shifting in favor of large manufacturers.
अभी क्या ईवे बिल के चक्कर में एक आदमी को और लगाना पड़ता है वो आदमी को टाइम पे फोन करो वो आएगा ईवे बिल बनाएगा मेरे को महीने का खर्चा बढ़ गया कम से कम नहीं भी बोलेगा तो 10 से 15 हज़ार तक बढ़ गया.
और आपका जो कमाई हो रहा था वो कितना?
पहले से कम हो गया कमाई पहले से कम नहीं भी बोलेगा तो 30-35 हज़ार तक का कमाई कम हो गया हर महीने में.
द बिजनेस इज गेटिंग ट्रांसफर्ड टू ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर because a manufacturer who has more than 1000 loom and a manufacturer who has 50 looms maintaining these all the accounting system the cost for both is same which is affecting small and medium scale industry people.
Companies are clinging to hope that the Maharashtra government will bring in some relaxation like other states, either in the value of goods transported or the kilometer criteria applicable for intrastate e-way bills. In Bhiwandi, Archana Shukla.
Okay, that's an on-ground report from Bhiwandi. But Finance and Revenue Secretary is speaking at the event marking 1 year of GST. Let's cut across to that.
So that's something we need to celebrate. Also, friends, this is a day of acknowledgement. Acknowledgement of contribution made by so many stakeholders in making GST. First and foremost, we would like to acknowledge the role of Union Cabinet led by Honorable Prime Minister for supporting this initiative. From day one, there was a political will expressed by him in saying that, yes, we have to do it within a year. As soon as they came, they gave us a mandate, clear mandate, that we want it to be brought. So political will is very important for any initiative. So we must acknowledge that today when we are celebrating the first year of GST. Second, we must acknowledge the role played by the GST Council, India's first federal executive decision-making body. And it was led by Honorable Finance Minister, Mr. Arun Jaitley. The way he steered the discussions there and the way the states also cooperated, it was really fantastic. It was a fantastic experience for all of us to see the quality of discussion, how the states are defending their interest, irrespective of the party line, and their willingness to sit through 27 meetings of the GST Council, and some of them spanning over 2 days or 3 days, and number of hours of discussions. Hundreds of decisions were taken in the GST Council meeting. Now, this is no less an achievement. It's a wonderful work put in by state and central government finance ministers. So I would like to acknowledge the role played by them on this occasion. The next, of course, is we must thank all the state governments for passing the GST bill in time. It was a record time within which 31 states passed their bills within a short period of 1.5 months, I remember. After the central government passed all the GST bills, the states also passed it in time. So we must acknowledge the role of state government. We must also acknowledge the role of the trade and industry, people who are present here, in making GST a success. Just as we had a lot of apprehensions, they also had a lot of apprehensions, how their business would be affected, whether the input tax credit will be available in time or not, whether the refund will come on time or not, all these apprehensions were there. But we must say that trade and industry stood by us, even the small-scale industry, and they have really played a major role in making GST a success. Wherever there was an information gap, they came forward to tell us so, and we tried to remove that information gap. So that's something we must acknowledge on this occasion. Finally, and not the least, I must acknowledge the role played by all my dear colleagues who are sitting here, some of them are sitting here. दिन रात एक करके उन्होंने कमाल कर दिया जितना काम हमारे जितना मैं उसका साक्षी हूं कि जितना काम हमारे सीबीआईसी के ऑफिसर्स और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के ऑफिसर्स ने रात दिन मिलकर किया है यू कांट इमेजिन कि अगर 27 मीटिंग जीएसटी काउंसिल की होनी है तो उसके पीछे एजेंडा बनाने में कितने दिन लगे होंगे हमको और कुछ कुछ तो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के ऑफिसर्स यहाँ महीने में 15-15 दिन तक पड़े रहते थे क्योंकि उनको काम करना था रात भर बैठ के और इतनी ज़्यादा आइटम के ऊपर सोचना नियम बनाना कानून बनाना नोटिफिकेशंस बनाना रेट स्ट्रक्चर बनाना रेवेन्यू की चिंता करना इट वॉज नॉट ए जॉक एंड इन फैक्ट दे हैव डन ए वंडरफुल वर्क एंड दिस इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल कि वेन देर इज ए क्लियर डिरेक्शन कमिंग फ्रॉम द पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप इवन द ऑफिशियल्स कैन कंट्रीब्यूट अ लॉट So I'm thankful to all those colleagues of mine who have made GST a success on this day. And finally, of course, a lot of people mentioned about the figure of 1 lakh crore. Sirf ek mahine mein aaya hai abhi. Jo April mein aaya, wo 1 lakh 3 crore tak pahunch gaya, lekin logon ne shayad ye sochna shuru kar diya ki ab 1 lakh to norm ban gaya hai. But let me tell you ki it's not the norm still. The average collection of 9 months of 17-18, which ended in March, was 89,885 per month. 89,885 per month. In the month of April, of course, all of you know the figure that you quoted, 1,03,000 crore is what we got, but that was a March effect. In May, we got 94,016 crore in May, 1 month's collection. And June figure, which ended yesterday, I'm willing to disclose it now because we have the figure with us. The June figure of collection is 95,610. So there is an increase of about 1,600 crore between May and June. And we hope, and we do hope, that we want to bring it to the level of 1 lakh crore with the cooperation of trade and industry. And as some chamber president has mentioned, that let us not start accepting bogus bills. And once we have a shakti in this, it will happen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. अब मैं माननीय वित्त
good at 95,610 crores. Earlier in May, the collection was 94,000 odd crores. Remember, in April, we had seen a collection figure of 1 lakh crore, but Mr. Adia goes on to say that is still not the norm, expecting a figure of 1 lakh crore per month. But June figures have been a bit have shown a bit of improvement at 95,610 crores. He also went on to acknowledge the efforts of all the bureaucrats as well as employees. He acknowledged the fact that the clear mandate and the political will to implement GST went a long way in the smooth implementation, and also how the GST council members worked together and came across for the 27 meetings on GST went a long way. Also, he acknowledged the way the state governments came in together and passed the bill in record time of just 1.5 months, and not to mention that the trade and industry also came in handy and worked on for the smooth implementation. He talked about how they had to go through multiple ups and downs. There were a lot of changes that were involved as far as the tax regimes is concerned. They had to work on the returns as well as increasing the compliance. But it has been a good journey for GST so far as what he says. Let's in fact cut across back to the event where Mr. Shukla is talking about GST as well.
Two logon ko badhai dene ka kaam kiya, Ramesh ji ko ki aaj ke sitting ke liye aur Banjar Sarna ji ko ek nayi zindagi shuru karne ke liye. कभी कभी कुछ ऐसे परिवर्तन होते हैं जो इतिहास बन जाते हैं, और मुझे ध्यान है कि 30 जून 17 को रात में मध्यरात्रि में, जब मध्यरात्रि की बात आती है तो दो ऐसी घटनाएं आती हैं जिसमें मध्यरात्रि में भी सांसद बैठ करके कुछ निर्णय लेते हैं, और वह दो ही दृष्टांत आए, दो ही घटनाएं आई. स्वतंत्रता के बाद वह प्रथम क्षण था जब हम इस देश को आज़ादी का उल्लास मना रहे थे, उसी सेंट्रल हॉल में तब घोषणा हो रही थी देश की आज़ादी की. और दूसरी घटना वह आई कि 17 कानूनों के बंधन को तोड़ करके एक कानून बनाने के जीएसटी के इस दृष्टांत पर भी उसी मध्यरात्रि को उस दिन घोषणा हो रही थी. महामहिम राष्ट्रपति जी, माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी घोषणा कर रहे थे और लोग उल्लसित भाव से देख रहे थे. तो कभी इतिहास बन जाता है, जीएसटी का निर्णय भी एक इतिहास बन गया. अनेक परिवर्तन आए, मैं जब सामने देखता हूं तो कई चीजें, हसमुख अढ़िया साहब कह रहे थे लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि शायद एक चीज भूल गए. जिस समय जीएसटी काउंसिल्स की मीटिंग हुआ करती थी उस समय चीफ एडवाइज़र अरविंद जी का वह घूमती हुई कुर्सी कभी भूलती नहीं है मुझे. सबको डायरेक्ट किया करते थे. आज का क्षण अनुभव बांटने और कहने का ही है. मैं थोड़े बाद में आया, कई मीटिंगों के बाद आया. बाद में प्रधानमंत्री जी ने इस विभाग में मुझे भेजा. लेकिन मैं ये कह सकता हूँ कि इतने समय में जो मैंने देखा, तो मुझे ध्यान है कि एक पिक्चर आई हुई थी जिस पिक्चर का कि ये गीत थी कि अंबर में वो बैठा बैठा देख रहा है अपनी रचना। आज मैं ये कह सकता हूँ कि कहीं किसी जगह बैठ करके श्री अरुण जेटली जी भी अपनी रचना को देख रहे होंगे। जिस तरह से उन्होंने संयम की पराकाष्ठा की, परिश्रम की पराकाष्ठा की, और जिस मैं तो पहली मीटिंग में जब गया तो उन्होंने कहा बस बैठ के सुनते रहो, धीरे धीरे सब जान जाओगे। लेकिन जो रचना इन लोगों ने, जो बैठे हुए हैं इन लोगों ने उनके साथ मिल करके किया, आज उसकी सराहना संपूर्ण भारत में वह लोग भी कर रहे हैं जो कभी भी टैक्स को जानते ही नहीं थे। छोटे से छोटे व्यापारी जो कभी बिल भी नहीं काटे थे, उनको भी लगा कि नहीं, मुझे भी देश के साथ जुड़ना चाहिए, मुझे भी टैक्स भरना चाहिए। यही सबसे बड़ी बात है, टैक्स भरना चाहिए। लोगों ने इसको स्वीकृति दिया। आज जीएसटी की सबसे बड़ी खूबसूरती यही है कि लोग देश के साथ जुड़ रहे हैं, एक देश एक टैक्स। तो जो 17 अब हम देखें तो कहां, जब एक आध जगह चर्चा हुई 28% पर, तो हम ये सोचते थे कि प्रत्यक्ष और अप्रत्यक्ष करों के जो जंजाल थे उसमें तो मुझे लगता है कि 32% ऑफ द टैक्स लोगों को देना पड़ता था, और यहां तो केवल शायद 50 वस्तु है, लेकिन मुझे लगता है शायद 49 ही वस्तु है। 49 वस्तुओं पर ही केवल 28% का टैक्स है। धीरे धीरे हम उसको कम करते रहे, शायद 10 नवंबर 17 को।
Okay, that's Mr. Shukla, Minister of State of Finance, talking about the one year journey of GST and the hits and misses, and also complimenting the council, the officers, as well as the bureaucrats to come together and ensure a smooth implementation. But when GST was first mooted, Tamil Nadu was not completely sold on the new tax regime. A year since then, the tax effect has come into effect. The state's coffers have reaped a healthy dividend. The CNBC TV18's Jude Sanat took a closer look at the life of taxpayers in the state and found that the MSME sector has not had a very smooth sailing where the tax is concerned.
For Tamil Nadu's coffers, goods and services tax has been a godsend. In the 9 months of FY18, when GST was operational, the state has earned 87,000 crore rupees in GST collections. That's massive when the state's total tax collections for FY18 came in at 99,000 crore rupees. So the state exchequer may not be complaining about GST anymore. But 5 industries in the MSME sector are. So the state government is studying the stress caused by GST to units working in the automotive, textiles, leather, electrical and electronics, and general engineering sectors.
Final report is awaited. So once that comes, we will take it up, especially for those sectors we are going to provide some assistance.
While helpful, subsidies alone may not be the solution. The pain point of GST is best understood in the electronics sector. Take a printed circuit board, for instance, which requires components from 100 different suppliers. Only 65% of these suppliers, manufacturers say, have acclimatized to the new tax regime. For the remaining 35%, GST refunds are still proving problematic.
Refunds haven't yet come. You know, that process is, I think even though government has speeded up that process, I think there is still a lot of pending refunds that are out there. So I think that affects their cash flow, and so that's a pain point for some of our suppliers.
Delayed payments and a spike in capital requirements have not helped either. MSMEs add that banks are hesitant to lend, and this has worsened the fund crunch. As per state government statistics, FY18 saw 50,000 fewer companies register as MSMEs under the Udyog Aadhaar scheme than the previous year. It also saw 5 lakh fewer jobs being created.
Things, however, seem to be improving since FY19 began, with 89,924 companies registering in the first couple of months.
If I look at our supplier base, we are very bullish. I mean, we are looking at localization going up from 25% to 50%. And in the last 2.5 years, we have established close to 140 suppliers in and around Chennai.
Several other manufacturers, especially in the automobile and electronic space, also plan to boost localization. And this, along with the Tamil Nadu government's plan to offer a subsidy for GST-hit MSMEs and soon-to-be-unveiled electronics policy, could be a ray of light at the end of the tunnel. In Chennai, Jude Sanath.
Okay, that's an on-ground report from Chennai telling you that it has not been very smooth sailing for all MSME sectors like electronics. But let's cut back across to that event that's been celebrating the 1 year of GST in Delhi. Let's listen in to Mr. Shiv Pratap Shukla, who is the Minister of State of Finance in Delhi.
आप सभी लोगों को इस बात के लिए धन्यवाद दूंगा। मैं आज के दिन तो निश्चित रूप से इस ट्रेड से जुड़े हुए किसी के प्रति कोई अन्य शब्द नहीं कह सकता हूं। मैं इतना ही कह सकता हूं कि सभी लोगों ने मन से जीएसटी को स्वीकारा, सभी लोगों ने मन से इस टैक्स को बनाने वाले लोगों के परिश्रम को स्वीकारा और सभी लोगों ने कभी भूल से घर में बैठ करके भी जो नई चर्चा करते रहे वह इस टैक्स के माध्यम से इस देश की एकात्मता को स्वीकारा है। यही सबसे बड़ी खूबसूरती रही है जो आपके माध्यम से मैं देशवासियों से भी शेयर करना चाहता हूं। आपको धन्यवाद, उनको भी धन्यवाद जिन्होंने जीएसटी को अपनाया और उनको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद जिन्होंने जीएसटी को बनाने में अपना एक एक दिन एक एक रात एक एक क्षण लगा दिया। धन्यवाद।
धन्यवाद माननीय।